Hello folks, today I'm going to be painting an arc and talking about the process behind, so let's jump right in. This is my first tutorial on YouTube, so please show some support and subscribe to my channel. So I started with a basic silhouette. At this point I'm just blocking in the main shapes. Then I thought of a light source, which is coming from the left. So I'm developing some highlights on his face, so that the facial features become more prominent. Some highlights on the shoulders. At this moment I'm just trying to figure out the shape of the head. There's something wrong with the forehead and the nose looks really weird, so I fixed it here real quick. This is where the hair comes. At this moment, I'm not really worried about the background. I'll deal with that later. And the curly hair. Isn't that odd? An arc with hobbit hair? Might look good. Let's see. Right now, I'm just color picking and making some corrections. Some strong highlights on the face. So it's a shoulder guard made of leather. I put some little metallic rings on it so it can be tied to the chest armor below. Let's give him a little earring. This orc does not have an ear, but he is still wearing an earring. Look at that. If you can't draw an ear, you gotta hide it in shadow, right? Here I added some hint of a background. I'm using a large texture brush to just create some visual noise in the back so that it does not look very plain and flat. And the tasty part, the rim light. So I'm creating this sharp rim light at the edge of the character's face. And then I thought I'd just create a rim light from the back of his head and not at the front. So there are two light sources at the moment. The one is the ambient light, which is on the left, lighting up the character's face. It is the light source that is present in a scene before any additional light source is added. So you can call it a basic light source. Then there is a light coming from the right and it has a higher intensity. All right, I'm finally adding a hint of the ear. Let's see how it looks. Yeah, it looks fine. I think I'm gonna go with it. Some more light on the hair. So the light coming from the right will also affect the background, right? So I'm adding some brighter values on the back. Some grays over here. So here I'm using a large soft round brush with the black color selected. And I turn the opacity down to maybe 15%. And I cover some edges. Makes your eyes stay within the canvas and on your main subject, which is a little sad arc here. Some highlights on the face. And what's missing? Yes, orc teeth. That's what we are gonna make. And here you go, fine little teeth. Good luck with eating an apple with those. I'm continuously color picking while painting. It's like sculpting in 2D. So orcs in the Lord of the Rings trilogy and orcs in Blizzard's World of Warcraft. Both are very distinctive and different. Which ones do you like better? Let me know in the comments down below. some strings tying the armor pieces together. Mostly when I'm working for a client, I look up for reference images for different armor types. It really helps you get some fine looking details in your painting, like different straps and belts and, you know, the small little details that we take for granted. You gotta think about the practicality too, like how the armor pieces are attached together and the different materials that are used. I noticed that this part of the shoulder kinda looks too bright. I think the upper part should be in the shadow, so I'm fixing it right now. Looks better now. Some more highlights on the armor and the face. I'm just fixing things up at the moment, because then I'll add color. I decided to flip the canvas and guess what? It looks way better this way. I draw from my right hand and for some reason I always end up drawing characters that are facing the left side. It's weird. So here I'm fixing things up and at the same time thinking about what can be added into this painting. So I added some snow. I'll try to animate some snow at the end of the video to make it look a little bit more cinematic. I created the snow on a separate layer so that I can add the motion blur filter on it. When you're painting a scene, you gotta think about the environment that you're painting. Like, how does it feel to be there? How is the weather? Is it warm? Is it cold? What are the sounds that you're possibly hearing in that environment? What does it look like? What does it smell like? It really helps you establish a mood in the painting. I think we are good to go. So let's color this now. So I grouped all the layers and made a copy of that group. I hit Ctrl E and that copied group gets converted into a single layer. I then go to Image, Adjustments and Gradient Map. I select some colors for the highlight and for the shadows. I'm trying to create some blue tones here. At this point it looks good, everything is nice and clear, but the image looks kind of monochromatic. There are not many colors in this painting, which is probably fine, but I'll just experiment with adding some colors on top. Let's see how it looks. So I selected some browns for the armor and some greens for the face. I set the blending mode to color and paint on a separate layer. Some more highlights to make the face a little bit more prominent. I thought, why not add some light source? I mean, this orc, I don't know why he's standing in the middle of the forest and it's so freaking cold. He'll probably freeze to death. So let's add some fire for him. So I chose a warmer tone and set the blending mode to color dodge. And then I selected a large soft round brush with lower opacity and just lightly painted over on top to create some light coming from the campfire. I added some strong highlights on his face, hinting that there is a light source at the bottom. Some details here. Some of the light hitting the trees. When you're painting, it's not really necessary to think about all the details first. You gotta break down things into simpler shapes and fewer brushstrokes. Think about creating an impression or a hint of the thing you're painting. Yeah, that's about it. Our Hobbit Orc Captain is ready to roll. I hope you guys enjoy this video, hope you learned a thing or two. Please subscribe to my channel if you want to see more of this stuff. If you like this video, please hit the like button and comment what you'd like to see in the next video. Thank you and have a great day, people.